They said I would find you out here. Edwina Mountbatten.
I could have waited in the cool hall, but I was curious to see your Mughal garden.
It's your garden, Mr. Gandhi. We are merely the trustees.
You know, for the Mughals, the garden was a glimpse of heaven. They drew inspiration from Holy Quran, modifying and adapting what was found to make a paradise on earth. All elements perfectly blended.
The gentlemen of the press are here and would like us to pose for photographs.
Oh, then we must show them our best faces.
You have what you want, Mr. Dillon.
And Punjab?
I don't think Nehru will give you that.
The Muslim League will never accept a Pakistan without Punjab.
Yes, I read your article in the newspaper.
All of it.
It's good tactics to retreat while sounding the charge. Because retreat you must. And then everybody can start to compromise.
Leave me with a moth-eaten Pakistan.
There is still time to stop me recommending partition, Mr. Jinnah. No need to divide Punjab. No need to reduce Lahore. Guarantees for the Muslim people built into the constitution. You, a father of that constitution. India, unpartitioned with its united army and navy. We're talking about what would surely be the greatest power in Asia.
You are talking about it, not me.
Long years ago, we made a tryst with destiny. And now the time comes when we shall redeem our pledge, not wholly or in full measure, but very substantially. At the stroke of the midnight hour, when the world sleeps, India will awake to life and freedom. A moment comes which comes but rarely in history. When we step out from the old to the new, when an age ends, and when the soul of a nation long suppressed finds utterance. We are a free and sovereign people today and have rid ourselves of the burden of the past. We look at the world with clear and friendly eyes and at the future with faith and confidence.
Fairly thick skin, but I'm finding this more than I can bear.
During the war, I remember, at a morgue, they lined the dead up in rows. Just like pheasants.
It's not the dead. It's the savages that kill them. They're worse than animals. I think I'm losing faith in my own people.